I just wanted to show you about the immigration that one town in Italy takes these migrants from Etruria. Now, Etruria is a territory of Italy, so by right, they have a right to stay there, and they get boat service from Etruria, which is in Africa, and they're letting them come in this small little village that's been abandoned for over 400 years. Because the natives went to Australia, the native Italians. So they're letting these people come in from Etruria. They have to be Etruria because Etruria does speak Italian as a second language. So they let Riassi, they let them come because they are considered citizens. Now it's all the way down here. And it's abandoned. It's not a bad idea. But it's also not a good idea. The reason why I say this is because all it takes is one of them to migrate to another part of the Italy. And the mayor is trying to tell them that this is good to the townspeople. And that these people want to come here. They come from Egypt. Now, his ideas are human in it. His ideas are good. But it's not going to work. Because, first of all, they're going to go off to other parts of Italy and start merging and start growing in numbers. And now the population is going to start to diminish because Italy had a big migration to the Americas in the 1880s is when my great-grandparents came. They came from not that part of Italy, farther up, to come to America for a better life. They came on an immigration boat and they had to pass health checks. And if you weren't healthy, you were sent back. As you can see, it's a nice little village. I wish I could get, you know what? I would love to live there. I would go in 5 minutes if I didn't have a husband and family members to take care of. I would go. But in my retirement, yes, I probably will go. And I'll take one of those houses in 5 minutes, as long as there's running water, and just paint it up, and I buy furniture, okay? These are abandoned, and he's trying to tell them that because of the regular people who left, there's nobody there but old people. Okay, so what? The old people don't mind as long as they stay out of trouble and they don't make trouble in the town. Okay, that's not a good, bad idea. But what's going to happen is that those kids are gonna have kids with girls. You know, they're going to have babies and make more babies and make more babies. And then who's going to pay for it all if there's no work in an abandoned town? Okay? There's no work in these towns. They're abandoned old towns. Who is going to pay for all of this? The Italian taxpayers, which is the government, because all governments of the West take from the taxpayers, and the governments get tax exemptions on helping immigrants into villages and towns. They get tax write-offs, so they get money back, okay? And this is beautiful, by the way, and it's very, very pretty. And these are the Egyptian kids and the parents and the children. They don't want to, what about little Italian children? They're not there anymore. They can't fix the town up and make it affordable for tourists or people from the West that would love to live there. Okay, she's learning an old culture that probably started in her day, and they get along. Okay, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not against it. But there's pitfalls. And this lady who's a native says, well, you know, now they're becoming shops and they're owning shops and villages where they could give it to us and let us own property and have shops and villages. This is going to be a mistake they're going to make, and they're going to be just like England. Because once you let one in, you've got to let them all in, just like America. And you never have anything kept to yourself, and you can't pass it on to your family if you want to, or if you want to sell it or rent it out. So she's saying this is a bad idea, which she's got a point. It's going to become a problem. Now, these are the Italian people. They're older, 50s, 40s, 60s, 70s, whatever, 90s. Why can't they keep it the way it was? So you get tourists come. You get Westerners to come live there. Who's going to pay for all their food and lodging? Now, this little boy is from Egypt. He's sad. He misses his mother. Well, send him back home. Who cares? keeping their prisoner against his will. Why did they let them come up in the first place? They don't really want to be there. He's unhappy. He's not eating. You could see that. Send him home. Well, he could be with his... So this is civil war. Well, that's, you know what? It's the West's fault for creating that problem in Egypt. It's the West's fault. They need to be held accountable. The governments of the West for doing it to these people, for displacing them, and making everybody else not have to put up with it, and taxpayers have to pay for everything. And American taxpayers too, you know. We pay for everything in the whole world. It's gonna happen. They're gonna start marrying the local Italian girls, if there are any, because there's nobody in the town anymore. And they're gonna start breeding these mulatto kids. You know, we don't, you know, it's enough with miscegenation, because it's not going to make a nation stand. It only divides. And this country has had a big share of it. And it really don't keep people together. And it's not because it's a bad thing. It's because it doesn't keep the races intact. Now, they get $700 a month to live in these old abandoned houses. I wish somebody would pay me $700 a month to live in an old abandoned house. I would go in 5 freaking minutes. And there's no work, there's no shoppers, because the people of the town are old or they moved out. He says he's got 1 year to stay, this guy who owns a bag shop. No one's going to go in and buy anything. Nobody has any money. Why? When are people going to learn the West is broke? It's busted through all of these immigration, miscegenation, welfare, everything that we pay for. It's busted. The government's bankrupt everyone in this country, and I'm sure they bankrupted them in their country, and nobody has money to shop. He's getting $700 a month to stay in Italy. Someone give me $700 a month and I'll go back. Well, I wasn't born there, but I would go in 5 minutes. He says, after 1 year, you'll have to leave. Now, who's going to kick him out? They're making, picking up recycled stuff and making money on it. How could you make a living off of that? This guy is living in one of these old shanty apartment complexes from the village. He's got a TV. Even my own mother doesn't have a decent television set. Come on. $700 a month. Who's paying for it? The government. The Italian government is giving them a chair, a bed, a couch, or whatever, a stove. Hey, it's better than living in the shanty towns that they came from. But who's paying for it? Taxpayers. Stove, all right, it's not a Taj Mahal. But listen, there's some people in this country who live worse than that and pay taxes. Come on. He won't have any money after the project. It's a project. They have a program going. You know, they're going to go bankrupt if they keep doing this, because their own people are starving over there. There's no food stamp program in Italy. Now, Italy is upset because they live in the community that have abandoned these. I live in these apartment buildings. Let me go. How about some people from this country that have no jobs? Give us $700 a month and we'll live there and keep it nice and grow a garden and make it pretty and keep the streets clean. Now, the people in the area, they don't want this. I mean, what do you want them to do? She has a baby and a mortgage. She doesn't want her kids growing up, she says, in a refugee camp. I mean, what do you want the people to do? They can't flip the bill for every person who's poor. So many of us are poor. No one's flipping the bill for white people. Okay? These people get bus service and boat service. These people are pissed off. Come on already. You can't have everybody come. This guy's saying, what is this? Only Etrians are allowed to come because they're citizens. But not everybody else. And they sneak in with the Etrians, and you can't tell, you know, who's who. They're not giving them checks with their name or fingerprinting like they do in this country. It's a Nazi state here. And they treat people in this country like trash, especially the white people. And I'm not a racist. I know what I'm speaking about. The people are fed up. There's no work. There's no decent jobs. Not here, not over there. Go to South America. Why doesn't South America take them? I'm sure they would love it. But they have poor people there too. They can't afford to flip the bill for everybody. White people don't have money, or working people of any color that matters, that pays taxes, not just white people. But the majority, the brunt of it comes from people who are Caucasian and pay high taxes and everything, their paychecks and their homes, their utility bills, their credit cards, their food. This girl is upset because there's too many coming in. Do you want one to come in and another one? There's no jobs for any of those people. There's no food for any of them. They're hungry in Italy. They've got to grow food in the local garden. And they don't have supermarkets. They have little superettes, but they have fresh markets and things. And they're tired of it. They don't want this anymore. No country should have to put up with it. This country has been bankrupt, and it will be continually to get bankrupt, and it'll be imploded, and it will be nuked. Because the people of this country can't afford to pay for everybody else either. And these people don't have it to pay for them. They don't even have money to pay for their own citizens. And they get $700, just like here.